morning, guys, and welcome back to another day. Well, got here last night, and spoke with a dog runner. I asked him to park up the trailers next to me, since there was an bay available. Someone that was parked in a bay next to me left after I got here and I went to bed. So I wake up this morning, and when I look, yes, the trailer is parked next to me, but next to my cab, almost, not right at the end of the line where I can just go in a front, reverse, and hook up. So I can still, I think I can do that. I'll give it a try, but that means I'll have to go as far as I can and then to reverse back. So yeah, if someone is coming, I'm gonna be a bit on their way. Yeah, when people are not following simple instructions, it's a bit inconvenient sometimes. Yeah, so this is what happened. Instead of leaving at the end, where I can easy just go in the front of it and hook up, he left it almost at the front of the bay. In front of other people, then I will just unhook and push it back ahead of the line and then come and do it. Okay, so finally managed to hook up. Was an awkward position there, not enough room at the front, had to do a few back and forth, but it's done. Now I'll take a drive through the yard and recheck again everything before heading up the highway. So it's all locked in, all good. Yep. I'll try and sign with the back, lights working. So this is the combination that I have to take up to Newman. Myself a coffee and then head up the road. Thank you. coffee mug at home again, so I'm reusing the old caps from BP. Strong coffee, but this one is gonna last me probably all the way to Gappy. Northbound out of hookup. Okay. Fully loaded on our way to Newman. Looks a bit heavy. Sometimes it is a bit hard when not the full informations are passed to you. I know it's under, it's not overloaded, but how heavy is? I don't know, the one which the dog ran about, my dog.
You okay now?
So I took a call to set up that one as a dog, but just from looking in the paperwork and estimating the load and the weight. So yeah, it is, should be the lightest one, but it's 50-50 that can be a bit heavier than I was estimating. Because you know how many tubs of linen you got, you know how many pallets of that and that, but sometimes that can be light, sometimes that can be heavy, the tubs of linen especially. You don't know how much is in them and what's most of the product in them. And you are just having a rough estimate. Can't be sure, so that's what's giving you something to work on it. But yeah, it should be the lightest, but yeah, we'll see how it's gonna sit behind me. We'll sit nice and straight, or it keep his name as a dog and will be the doggy tile. Three trailers to unload, plus one of my colleagues is bringing up to Newman a trailer which is half for him, half for me. So after doing this, I'll be going to road train area and pick up that one and unload it as well, that half trailer which will be left there for me. Part of that, it's the inland, it's a bit more quiet than the coastal. I'm not expecting much traffic today, being Saturday. Weather is not that bright, it's a bit overcast. But as long as it's keeping like this and no wind, no rain, I'll be happy. Well, my estimates were really good, because all three trailers are sitting so nice and straight on a road. Not even the smallest movement. They are following each other perfect. What can I say after the coastal run? Well, it's a bit of a mixed bag. In one way, I would like to go more on the inland. The road is Guaida most of the time, less caravans and small vehicles to deal with. Yeah, okay, there are a few big oversizes, but you learn to deal with them very quick. You already know once the pilot is telling you how big it is. You'll know what to do straight away after a while. I mean, anything after 5 meters or 5.5, you pull on the side of the road. Unless the road is super wide, and yeah, you have no problem. But if it's something like here, and it's telling you are 4.8, yep, you're good. You just go on the edge of the black and you'll be just perfect. On this one, 5.5, it's a bit too big because it doesn't have big shoulders at all. So yeah, very, very quick you learn what you need to do once you know how big the oversize is. Also, it's not that hilly, it's a lot easier to control this truck. I mean, driving a 909 or something like that on a coastal is a different story. They got a lot stronger exhaust brakes. You are pretty well set up. But with this, with the Volvo, exhaust brake most of the time is not enough. You have to jump on your foot brake and hold it, and yeah, it's a bit different. When on this road, it's performing very, very well. It's not a big descent or anything like that, so you leave your exhaust brake on and you are good, nothing happened. Doesn't go over speed or anything like that, but on the coastal, this one does go quite a bit if you are not careful. All of a sudden, it's running away with 104, 105, if you are not watching proper. It's different sceneries all over there, all that, but how I said, it's a bit of a mixed bag. You miss some of the stuff from here, and then you go, you come back here, and you miss some of the stuff from there. It's, yeah, I don't know. But I still tend to prefer more the inland than the coastal. But unfortunately, it's all part of the job, and I'll take it the way it is. One run coastal, one run inland. One run coastal, then off. Then another coastal, then one inland. And so on. saying that, as I said before, between Coastal Drive and this one, it's a bit of a mixed bag. Yeah, the only thing which I don't miss is the dirt roads. Not because they are more hard to drive on and they are rough and that, nah, that doesn't bother me at all. Is the blurry dust and how much I fight the bastard to get out of the cab every time. Everywhere you look after going 100 k's or so on a dirt road, you'll see dust, red dust in a cab, on a dashboard, everywhere. And the hardest part to clean is the air vents. Yeah, okay, the air con and this, they got filters, doesn't matter. This blurry dust is so fine, it can go through the filters. It can go through the air filters and still come inside of the cab, through the vents. After Marble Bar Road and then to Tom Price on Natara Road, was so much dust. So much dust inside of the cab, took me more than an hour just to clean up and wipe off all it, and still is still some left. I couldn't get everything, but slowly, slowly I will get it out now. So this is the only problem with the dirt roads that I have, the dust inside of the cab. It was an old truck, didn't bother me, but yeah, it's brand new and I like to keep it clean. But that's why I was gonna be more happy to give me one of the old bonnets to do that run than this one brand new to put it, to put a poor bastard through hell on that run. But was not my call, couldn't do anything, so I went with the flow.
Thanks, Jeff and folks.
Okay, so we have the first oversize today. 5.5. Road is narrow, so I'll have to go hard on the left. May need to jump off road a little bit. Okay, so this is done, and apparently there is one going north in front of us, so don't know how big is that one, don't know anything about it, didn't hear yet. Or should wait and see. Okay, so there are two, not one, and 8 meters. Ton piece of machinery. So see what happens.
Mate, you got a fox coming to you. Alright. Another one for the next big flubber.
Been behind them for the last 5 kilometers and maybe for another 5 or 10. The road is way too narrow for overtaking something like this, so yeah, it is what it is. Well, at the end of the day, at the end of the day, doesn't matter when we get there. What matters is to get there. So if something like this gets in your way, so be it. Just sit back, relax, and when the right time is coming, just go pass and see you later.
Beautiful, thanks, Carla.
It's a bit useless. He's calling you around, but he's still sitting in your way.
You're passing on your left, man. On your right.
It's all clear out the front if you want to get rid of those LVs.
Thank you, man.
One big one's coming, shoot.
Hey, Cleary.
Have a look at these two peanuts. Believe that two guys overtaking each other.
Come in.
I'm having a diesel, so rather than overtake this wide lane, we might just pull off.
Okay.
Just stick behind him until he's on a truck park.
he's coming into you.
Okay.
And you've got two heavies following up now. Yeah.
Get into Magnet. Usually it's taking 3 hours and 10 minutes, 15 minutes at the most. Now it's an extra 10 minutes added to the journey because of the oversizes, but yeah, it is what it is. Still got plenty time, no problem. It's only that I won't be touching Mika in within the 5 hours. So my break will be somewhere in between.
Warmed up a little bit up here, just on the bend at the moment.
In between Q and Mika.
Yeah, done more than that for very long, but it's clear.
I just heard
Now, might be better if we see up our limb once we come and start going to the town over here, do you want
it? I'd reckon so.
Yeah, I just heard the guys on the oversizes that they are planning to stop for refueling in Q. So I won't bother stopping there. I'll go somewhere between halfway between Q and Mika and stop there for my break. Okay, so that's Q. What's going on here? bit quiet today, which is good. Wi-Fi, soft serves. A bit of drilling and exploration around here lately. Doesn't look like they found much, because there's no markings. It's yeah. All of a sudden, everyone disappeared. They went further up and a bit inland, and they trying to see what's there. Couldn't actually found much around here. The good deposits in queues are long gone by now. Getting close to get some rain around here. It's been track us all the way. So yeah, who knows? We'll see how it's on the other side of Mika, because usually that's where things change a bit. Okay, 1:45, 15 minutes to go. So, there's no point going around this guy. I'll just sit behind him. I can't justify the effort and the risk going around just to stop 15 minutes later. In the middle, but okay, lunch break. This guy didn't care, just parked in the middle. will be Capricornia.
Thank you.
Terra. Well, I don't need fuel, I don't need anything, so I don't need to stop. I do stop from time to time if I need a bit of fuel top up or to buy something from IGA, but never stop night time. That's during the day. Marina. $255,000, a bit of a boring drive, but that's okay. See how I feel. May break it down at the Grusa, make a coffee and then keep going. Yeah, just to make it a bit more interesting, not that boring.
Teamwork, stream work. on my way.
Marina. So after all, wasn't many oversized loads to bother me on a road today. Yeah, just a couple of them managed to avoid. Couple, so yeah, not bad. Not bad after all. From Cumarina will be another hour and a half to Capricornia. We'll see how I go with the fuel. If I need to top her up tonight or to do it tomorrow. I'll have enough to do all the work tomorrow, then I'll prepare to fill her up on the way back tomorrow. So like that, I'm sure that I'll have enough to get back to Perth without any dramas. In other words, it should be in Cumarina about 7:15, which is yeah, very reasonable. Well guys, it's almost 6 p.m. and guess what? Still 35 degrees outside. Ouch! Doesn't look good for tomorrow. Not at all. Will be alright when I'm unloading the fridges because they are nice and cool. But the dry ones, not so nice. I mean, if outside is getting around 40, inside there, it's a lot more. It's gonna be like in a sauna. Do the Russian style, to have one of the freezers running next to, jump in a cool room, then go unload two more pallets, jump back in a cool room instead of in a icy water, you know. Oh well, we'll see what happens. positive on a caravan. Will be chock-a-blocked. So now 150 to Capricornia. We'll still have phone coverage for about 15-20 kilometers, and then for about 100 kilometers nothing, and slowly we'll get some coverage in the last 30 kilometers. Bit patchy, but yeah, we'll still have a little bit, and then the last 10 will be good.
The CPR's on your right hand side, mate, they're pretty close to the road. Thanks, mate, you have a good night.
Okay,
cheers,
so,
mate.
So a few k's up the road, they are on the side there. This guy just told the truck in front of me, the K-Trans guy. I always let people know, and I appreciate when others are letting us know, but yeah, sometimes there are some which are in their little la-la land and don't care about what's happening. They just listen to their audiobooks and they can't be bothered letting anyone know that it's a danger on the road or anything. Okay, there they are. They are still thinking to cross or not. Well, this is not one of their regular spots.
Stay northbound, a few cows on the road. For the next 70 kilometres, either side, they're chilling on their main phone. Yeah, nice fun, mate. Thank you very much. You're clear back that way. I haven't seen anything, so.
All right, mate, take care. Take care, mate, enjoy your night. So more here on the field, but they are not close to the road, so that's all good. The skid marks here. almost collide with them. The truck in front of me. And this place here, usually it's nothing, it's just dirt. It's not one of the... one of the usual spots where they are sitting. But because they are so dry, it's so dry, they are on a move, they search for moisture, for water, for... So, weather like this is becoming really dangerous. I didn't saw any day up because looks like when he hit the brakes and the noise of the wheels and all that scared them and they ran away, but yeah, you don't wanna end up with them in the front of you. Especially in a truck like this one, because it's got an anti-collision system and it will break hard. But it's amazing me that truck is still on the road. Because you saw, guys, the skid marks in the middle of the line. How can you explain all that dust and everything? That is because his dog, that might be middle trailer, went already on the way to buckle up. They already jumped out on the dirt. Okay. Looks like it was a crash here this afternoon. So easy to flip a trailer. to call southbound out of Cappy for that guy. But what can you do? Look at this one. Beautiful. Good on you, Mike. At Warawandu. I didn't stop at Cappy. I still got a quarter of the tanks, so plenty fuel. It's about 300 liters. The work that I have to do tomorrow, just inside there a couple of movements, then come back here to Newman, pick up the half trailer, go there, unload, come back to Newman, get my combination and go to Cappy, probably 60 k's, so Heaps of fuel. And like that, I'll fill her up tomorrow when I finish, and all the way to Perth. that he's gonna cross anywhere in my path, but yeah. We drive parallel. Okay, so I've arrived here at where I want to now. I need to separate the trailers to get the two that I need, leave the other one behind, because always they like to have the refrigerated ones first, and then I will come and get the third one, put them back together and take them to Newman and bring the half trailer from there. So yeah, now it's time to separate the trailers. Okay, so now I can pull the dolly out, leave enough room in between dolly and the trailer so I can put a prime mover under the trailer tomorrow when I need. So then I will drop the dolly and then I will be parking next to. And I'm done. Okay, all disconnected. So I'll got enough room between the dolly and the trailer to hook up. So now I'll just leave the dolly here, go around the block and come and park next to them, and I'll be all ready for the morning.